On a farm near Wellington, Western New South Wales, Virginia Wyke spends her day tending to her alpacas. Running a farm and working as a full-time nurse, her hands are always kept busy. But that's not all she manages to squeeze into her action-filled day. The 63-year-old also has a daring hobby that literally keeps the wind beneath her wings. Virginia loves to fly, and for the past three decades, she's been among the female pioneers in this male-dominated domain.
Years ago, women didn't fly, but now we've got Qantas captains, they're women. I was just in Sydney this week, down at Long Bay Jail, and going through the airport, I saw this lovely, tall woman captain. But there are lots of women pilots now. Things have changed, but it was a men's world once, but it's changed now. The women can do it too.
A close friend and mentor to Virginia was fellow aviatrix Nancy Bird Walton. A true pioneer for women in the cockpit, the Outback flyer and founder of the Australian Women Pilots Association was one of Virginia's biggest supporters. But Virginia's path to becoming the first Aboriginal woman to gain a pilot's licence began in 1982. The mother of two initially needed her licence to fly her husband from one farm to another. But from there, she flew on to bigger and more adventurous challenges. In 2001, Virginia competed in the London to Sydney air race.
Just to be able to enter, we were just so excited that we actually got in there, because most of the people in there, they were very wealthy people, and they had sort of bigger, better aeroplanes than what we had, and quite wealthy people. So we felt, you know, we felt very privileged to be able to join them.
Alongside her two co-pilots, Virginia spent a month flying across some of the world's greatest continents and oceans in a single-engine Cessna. She and a fellow Aboriginal co-pilot became the first Indigenous Australians to successfully finish the challenging route.
Probably one of the highlights of my life, and I'm sure Steve's life. So we learnt so much just by entering in the race, and even though we didn't win the race, there were about 35 aircraft and we came 17th out of 35, but we didn't care. We thought we'd won just by entering in the race.
Virginia hopes her story will encourage other women like her with a dream.
Where there is a will, there always is a way, but you have to really, really, really want to do something. And I really, really wanted to learn to fly. And when I heard about the air race, I really wanted to go in that air race.
For this woman, it seems the sky's the limit.